But still, the problem is that the curvature is just below 1, so from 0 to 0.11. Now we will create a small tool to fit this range. We cannot just use a fit range and fit it from 0 to and 0.1 to 0 and 1 because we don't really know the maximum value. For this, we will create a attribute promote. With this, you can measure the, for example, the area, the average, the minimum, the maximum value of all the points, and convert it into the detail attributes. So we want from points to detail. Let's say we want to convert the curvature attribute, and we don't want the average, but the minimum. Now let's look in the detail tab. You can see, okay, 0.0002. Let's just rename this to, let's say, min curvature. Now we have a min curvature of 0. Don't delete the original and duplicate it to get the now the maximum curvature. Change this to maximum. Now we have the max curvature, min curvature, and we still have the original curvature for each point. Now we can use these two values and fit our value you can see on the points to fit from this value to this value to 0 and 1. So let's do this also with an attribute wop. Dive in. And now we can import a detail attribute. Again, use ourself. So you could use op input 1, which is the first input, or you could just say here first input. So this value is not a vector 3, but a normal float. So let's change it back to float. Now we need a name because this should be one tool from here. We will promote our attribute to type it into the tool. For this, we will use a parameter. Use this as a string. String is basically just text. And say this should be the attribute name. And now, when we dive up, we will see an attribute name where we can type in curvature. And now we will search for these two attributes because we search for a detail attribute, but not for position, but rather for max curvature and min curvature. This is called now curvature. And now we will add a constant, also string, call this max and this min. And now we can just add these names. So we have min plus curvature as a name is min curvature. Then we can combine them. Say search for this detail attribute called min curvature and one for max curvature. And then we will fit our curvature. So let's append this to this. Now we have min curvature. Put this in there. Now we will have max curvature. Put this into the attribute and this into the attribute. And now fit our actual curvature attribute on the points. For this, we will use a bind to import our custom attribute. Everything that is not in here, you have to import it with a bind or with an import point attribute. And we use a bind export to again export our curvature. Both will be a float. And now fit this from the minimum curvature, which will be this minimum curvature from the detail attribute, the result to the maximum to 0 and 1. So now when we look again at the curvature attribute, we will see we have a 1 as the maximum and a 0 as the minimum. Because originally this attribute was 0.02, which is exactly the minimum curvature. So perfect. Now we have to clean it up to convert these nodes into our first digital asset. For this, we will also copy this parameter, paste it also into here. Now we have the new name will be max, and whatever attribute we type into here. So middle mouse click to see the actual result of it. Max curvature again here. Go back. Relative reference. So this is again a channel string, will be read from this node, attribute wop, and it searches for the attribute name, which is this curvature. It goes into there. This two things just mean it converts it into a string. Now we have min curvature. We also need this name in these inputs. And in here. Dive out. And now when we it should still work. And finally use the attribute delete sub to clear out these two detail attributes because we don't need them anymore. So we could just manually put these in, but again it would only delete them if the name would be min curvature. So let's just say delete maximum paste relative reference this and paste and delete the minimum and this value. So it will return in max curvature and min curvature. All right, now I can just see there is one expression missing up here in this curvature. So let's just put it in here as well. And in here as well. All right. Now we will only add one more feature, which will be a ramp. This will be applied after the fit. It will be a parameter ramp. You can use this to control the values between 0 and 1 by a ramp. So let's just leave this as ramp and call it ramp. We will change it to a spline ramp not a color ramp. And dive up. Now we have to put this up here. And what this does is basically, let's just visualize it again. So every value between 0 and 1 that will be fed into this node will be re-ramped by this ramp. So let's assume you put in a 0, then it will look on this side, so 0 to 1, and will apply the value from 0 to 1. So 0 is 0, then we have a linear ramp to 1, so when we feed in 1, it will return also 1. If we would switch this now, now every value that is inputted as a 0 will read here and will return 1. And when we feed in 1 from this, then we will get out 0. So with this, you can just re-ramp everything. You can't control it with this ramp, but with this ramp, let's just make a smoother transition so it's longer a 0 value or near 0 value, and the same with the higher values. Change everything to the B spline, not the linear, to get a smoother result. And now you could even clamp values from 0, though only if points are above 0.5, they have the chance to be over 0. Now we will have a hard edge or a smooth edge. All right. Now we will select everything. Right. Convert this into a subnet. You can press Shift and C. Call this something like global fit. A subnet is just like a folder. Here comes in the first input, and you can read it from this node. We won't use 2, 3, and 4, and we need a output node. So no matter what node we select in this network, every time this output node will result in this output one. Right click, create digital asset, call this global fit as well, and it will be saved in your documents folder, Houdini, and press accept. So now you can see only the inputs and outputs that are needed will be there anymore. So one input, one output. Parameters, we will use some of the parameters inside. The first parameter we need is the attribute name. We want to change it outside of the digital asset. Let's just drag it in here. And we also want to control the ramp. So let's just drag the ramp in here. Let's see. We don't need any other attribute. So go outside. And now you can just click accept. Now you have those two attributes outside here. And when you change this to, for example, test and go in again, now you will have the min test from the original point attribute. Also here, test, next test. here, this is directly linked to this attribute name from outside. Attribute delete, also max test, min test, dive inside, we have also test, and here we have a mistake. There is still the curvature. So let's again paste this value. Let's see, now it's test. Always control F, everything works. Okay, that should be fine. Now we will again save it and say match current definition. We just save it because we changed something in the notes and now we cannot edit it anymore. Now let's change it back to curvature, and because we have saved it as a digital asset, you can now go here, digital asset, and use the global fit again. We could add one more parameter. This would be the attribute type. Now we have the point attributes we can fit to 0 and 1. Let's just say allow editing of contents, dive inside again. Now we could also promote this attribute class on points, this as well, and that we run over points or primitives, for example. Now let's just do it, go outside again here, type properties. When you have a digital asset, you use type properties, otherwise you can use edit parameter interface. Dive in, just take this point, drag it in here above the ramp and press accept. Now this is linked, but not these. So let's again copy parameter and also paste it in here. Nice. So now when we change it to primitive and we have, for example, a primitive attribute, we can also just fit this primitive attribute from 0 to 1. When this would be point, there would be an arrow and it won't work. So this is why we added this function. But leave it 1 point for now. Change this back to point. Alright, again. Save it. And match current definition. Curvature and this predefined ramp will be the default values. You could change these by going again in type properties and here you could use a different name to change it as the defaults.